Okay, a lot of times when you're using a spreadsheet, you have lists of data and you have subgroups, and you might even have a total for all of it, and you really don't want to show what's in between. If that's the case, a great way to solve this is by using groups and subgroups, and I'm going to show you how to do that. So the data that we have is already subtotaled. If you look in the formula box, you use subtotal, and with the function number of 9. And I did it that way instead of summing it, because when you come down at the bottom and you do the subtotal again, it doesn't pick up all these other subtotals, so it doesn't count it. And I'm going to want to leave these rows exposed when I do my grouping. So I want to hide this data, but I want to have first quarter, second quarter, third, etc. showing. That's how I want to present it. So let's get rid of this data from view, but let's leave it in the formulas. Let's highlight all the rows that we want to get rid of. Notice I didn't highlight the header row and I did not highlight the subtotal row. Click anywhere in the data and let's do group rows 2 through 9. So what it did was it put this minus sign here in a bracket, and it shows you that, hey, if you click this, it's going to group or hide all of the data, okay, but keep the subtotals. We're going to go through and do that for all of these quarters. And when you have them grouped, it gives you a little button with the minus sign, which gives you the ability to hide them. So click on these to hide them, to kind of roll them up. And then you have a much easier to read presentation here where you're just showing the quarters. Now, if you want to hide the year as well, so to make two layers of groups, quarters and years, I'm going to expand all of these so you can see what I'm doing. And then go to the bottom of the data that you want to hide, which would be, we want to hide the subtotals here. So highlight that. I'm going to hold down the shift key and press the arrow key until I get to the top. I'm going to go one down, so I leave that header. And I'm going to right click and group all these rows, 2 through 31. It put another layer of grouping on here, so you can control either one. So you can, I can just do second quarter right now, or I can do the entire year. All the data stays underneath and you can toggle these on and off. You can also group columns together. In this example, it doesn't really make sense to do it, but I just wanted to show that you can do that and they can be on at the same time that the rows are grouped as well. So if I were to go through and hide these instead, it would have worked fine until you try to undo it, and then the rows wouldn't be selected anymore. But these stay here. So if you hide the data, you want to show it to someone in a simplified form, and then you want to expand it because you might want to change something, the grouping feature as opposed to hide works way better for that. If you like it better with the plus minus button at the bottom, you can just do that by using the right click menu, and that's an option. Let's move it back. And you can also collapse or expand all of them from this menu as well. So again, I'm just right clicking on this area to the left. And that's basically all. If you found that helpful and you want to see more tutorials like this, please subscribe in the lower right-hand corner. Thanks.